Welcome to session 7 of analog circuits module 2. In this session we are going to discuss the high frequency response. We have been discussing the common source amplifier characteristics and various parameters associated with that. So now in this session, let us take the high frequency response given by the common source amplifier circuit as shown in the picture here. So now in the previous session we have introduced some of the parameters like three frequency bands, mid band, low frequency band and the high frequency band, and also we have come to know what are the expressions for the mid band gain as well as what is the meaning of the bandwidth. So now in this session let us try to derive the gain of this common source amplifier where the circuit is under the influence of the high frequencies or the frequencies of the input signal. So therefore we will consider an equivalent circuit which is known as high frequency equivalent circuit for the particular common source amplifier circuit. Now here our intention is to find the gain or transfer function at high frequency, so that is particularly at the upper 3 dB frequency FH. Okay, so from the frequency response characteristics, okay, so we know that there is a FL and FH, so lower frequency and the high frequency band. In that, now we want to find out the gain or the transfer function at upper 3 dB frequency FH. So therefore, in order to proceed with the determination process, so we will have to always replace the MOSFET by its high frequency model, which is as shown in figure A here. Okay, and this is also known as high frequency amplifier equivalent circuit. Okay, so therefore in this circuit, equivalent circuit, you can observe that the CGD, CGS capacitances are there. Okay, so because now we have to consider how the gain is going to be influenced by all these internal capacitances. Okay, so therefore in this equivalent circuit, okay, whatever this capacitance CGD is there, so it is known as the bridging capacitor. This is known as the bridging capacitor. And the reason for calling it as a bridging capacitor is simply it is connecting input node to the output node. So here you can see that the CGD is between gate and the drain. So therefore at a drain we are also measuring the V naught. So therefore, so as it is coming in between gate and drain, so it is simply known as the bridging capacitor. Here the load current in this equation will be given as the difference between the currents that is given by GM into VGS minus IGD minus IGD. So this is what is the load current. Okay, so where GM VGS is the output current, GM into VGS is the output current, and IGD is the current which is supplied through the capacitor CGD. Okay, so the difference of these currents is taken as the load current. So now in the equivalent circuit, okay, so you can see that at the input side we have the resistor RG. So you can just observe this circuit diagram, what we have at the input, high resistor RG is there. Similarly we have RD connected to the drain as well as the RL is also there. So therefore in the model we have RG connected as well as there is a RD, RL, and they both will come in parallel with the R naught, which is nothing but the output resistance of the MOSFET. So GM into VGS is a dependent current source. So therefore, the circuit which comes under this blue shading is nothing but the equivalent circuit of the MOSFET it is. So remaining RSIG, RG, RD, RL, they are the external resistor connected to the amplifier circuit. Okay. So now here we have taken the parallel combination of R0, RD, RL as equivalent resistor RL dash. So therefore, from this circuit, we can write that RL dash will be equal to the parallel combination of output resistance of the MOSFET, drain resistor, as well as the load resistor. Okay, so this is one important substitution later in the simplified circuit. Okay, so therefore the three resistors in parallel can be simply replaced by now RL dash. So therefore, now with this resistor simplification, now we can readily write what is V naught. Okay, at the drain terminal. So therefore, here V naught is simply minus GM into VGS. This is current into resistance. So the resistance is RL dash. Okay, because V naught equal to I into R. I is nothing but GM VGS. R is nothing but the effective parallel resistance, that is RL dash. So this is nothing but minus GM RL dash into VGS, into VGS. Call this as equation 1. Now one thing you should observe here, that for VGS the notation is capital V, suffix is small GS. So this particular notation we have adopted just to indicate that the frequency analysis of the circuit, that's why. Okay, so otherwise in amplifiers we used to write small v and small gs to represent the small signal. Okay, so now here, as the analysis is associated with the frequency response, so we have slightly changed the notation. So uppercase V and the smaller case subscripts gs, so they indicate the source here. So equation now 1, it indicates the output voltage V naught at the drain terminal. So now still, what is our final intention is to find the transfer function or the gain of the circuit. Okay, so therefore now we will go on reducing the circuit so that we can write or we can arrive at the expression for this transfer function or the gain. Okay, now the equivalent circuit whatever shown in figure A can be further simplified by applying this Thevenin rule at the input side. Okay, because at the input side what we can see here, RSIG, that is signal source internal resistance, and RG, okay, so they are in parallel. So further it can be simplified, and we can write one simplified circuit which will be as shown here in figure B. Okay, so in figure B, we can observe that output side already it is three resistors in parallel are replaced by RL dash. So this GM into VGS current source as it is there, and this is CGD, which is a bridging capacitor, it is also present. So now at the input side, we have this CGS, gate to source capacitance CGS has come, and whatever the resistors were there, that is signal source internal resistors RSIG and the resistor high input resistance, that is RG, so their combination is now replaced by a single resistor RSIG dash. Okay, so therefore and also the signal source V dash SIG equal to RG divided by RG plus RSIG into VSIG. So this part is known as the Thevenin's equivalent circuit in order to reduce the equivalent circuit shown in figure A. Okay, so therefore here we can now find out the value of the current IGD, because GM into VGS is one part and IGD is nothing but a small current given by the resistor, the capacitor, CGD. Okay, so therefore the expression for this IGD will be, now this VGS minus V naught divided by impedance, divided by impedance of CGD. Okay, so this is equal to VGS minus V naught divided by 1 by J omega CGD. Okay, so this is because VGS is the voltage that appears at one plate, okay, and at the other plate what we have V naught. So therefore current through CGD will be difference of this potential divided by its impedance. Okay, so now this J omega, okay, so this J omega is replaced by a complex frequency variable S, which is going to simplify the algebraic manipulations. So therefore now with this replacement we can now write the expression for IGD as IGD will be equal to VGS minus V naught divided by 1 by S into CGD, 1 by S into CGD. Okay, or in other words, this IGD will be S into CGD VGS minus V naught. VGS minus V naught. So now already we know what is this V naught. So further substituting the V naught, we have VGS minus of minus GM into RL dash into VGS. Okay, so therefore finally the IGD current will be S into CGD into 1 plus GM RL dash into VGS. Okay, so we can take this VGS as a common factor, therefore IGD current is given by the expression, and we'll call it as a 2, equation 2. Okay, now in the equivalent circuit of as shown in figure B, so we know that the CGD has come in between the gate and source. So in order to further simplify the model, okay, the CGD can be replaced by an equivalent capacitor C equivalent, which is carrying the same current IGD between the gate and the ground terminal. So by doing so, it is further possible to simplify the circuit at the input side. Okay, so therefore now the circuit in B is further modified by replacing that CGD by one equivalent capacitance C equivalent. Okay, so therefore now we can see the modifications. At the output side, again the same combination is there, that is RL dash and GM into VGS. At the input side, this Thevenin equivalent already it is derived, but now the CGD, which was connecting between gate and drain and carrying IGD current, now the same CGD is replaced by C equivalent, which still carries the current IGD only between X and X dash in this equivalent circuit. Okay, so therefore circuit C shows a reduced form of equivalent circuit in B, where it is further possible to write the total input capacitance at the input section. Okay, so here it is given that C equivalent will be equal to CGD into 1 plus GM into RL dash. Okay, so why this C equivalent carries this value? So this is because uh, in figure C. Okay, whatever this capacitor SC equivalent VGS is there, this is equal to IGD, but IGD is again equal to S into CGD 1 plus GM RL dash into VGS. So this is from the previous equation 2. Okay, so here the equivalent capacitance C equivalent, it still carries the current IGD only, but IGD is equal to whatever it is mentioned in equation 2, that is S into CGD 1 plus GM RL dash VGS. So therefore now it is possible to write, so S into C equivalent VGS equal to S CGD 1 plus GM RL dash VGS. So therefore we can cancel some of the common terms here. So that is S as well as VGS gets cancelled. So therefore now what we have is the C equivalent is simply 1 plus GM into RL dash. So this is our equation 3. Okay, so therefore this is what is the simplification done with respect to that CGD capacitor with the help of IGD equation. Okay, so now equation the circuit C, equivalent circuit C further can be compared with what is known as STC circuit, that is single time constant circuit, which is of low pass type. Okay, so the input side in equivalent circuit C, it resembles a STC circuit of low pass type whose transfer function will be given like this. Now here I am drawing a STC circuit. It looks like this. It has one resistive component and one reactive component RC V0. Okay, STC means it is a single time constant. This is STC circuit. Now for such a circuit, the transfer function is given by the T of S is equal to K divided by 1 plus S by omega naught. So where K represents magnitude of the transfer function at omega equal to 0, and this omega naught represents the reciprocal of time constant, that is 1 by tau or 1 by R into C. This is what RC is, the time constant. Okay, so therefore our circuit, that is circuit as shown in figure C, now this can be recognized as that STC circuit. Okay, so therefore by just following the same analogy, we will have to write what is the expression for the output voltage VGS in case of our circuit. Okay, but in this circuit V0 is the output, that is why we have this transfer function T of S is equal to K divided by 1 plus S by omega naught. Now as we are writing all these equivalent circuits at the input side, okay, so at the input side, so VGS is a output, okay, or VGS can be now expressed as VGS is equal to RG by RG RSIG into signal source, this into 1 by 1 plus S by omega naught. Okay, so here the omega naught term, this is called as the corner frequency or the break frequency of the STC circuit. Okay, so now for this STC circuit we have omega naught equal to 1 by RC. Now we will apply the same concept to our equivalent circuit. So here in place of R we have R dash SIG, and in place of C we have to write now input capacitance C in. But what is this C in? C in is nothing but the parallel combination of CGS and C equivalent. Okay, so therefore now we will write in our circuit, that is in common source equivalent circuit, omega naught is given by 1 by omega naught is equal to 1 by C in R dash SIG. R dash SIG. Okay, so for the time being, let us call this this as equation 4 and this as equation 5. Okay, so R dash SIG, we know it is a resistance, and of course it is a parallel combination of, so I'll write here where R dash SIG is nothing but at the input side signal source resistance parallel with the RG. But what is this C in? Input capacitance. So from the circuit we can write, from this equivalent circuit shown in figure C, we can write C in is equal to CGS plus C equivalent. So this is equal to CGS plus C equivalent. But we know what is this C equivalent. See here, in equation 3 we have C equivalent value. So therefore substitute this here. Therefore C in is equal to CGS plus CGD into 1 plus GM into RL dash. Okay. So we will take this as equation 6. Okay, and R dash, we will call this as equation 6, and we will take this as equation 7, because they represent some important parameters in our discussion. So therefore now we have to actually derive what? The transfer function, that is the ratio of output by input. Output is V naught, input is VGS. Output is V naught, input is VGS. Okay. So therefore now it is possible to combine our equation 1. What is that actually? Equation 1 is, that is V naught equation. Okay, so combine this equation 1 and fourth equation, because in equation 4 we have what? VGS. Okay, so therefore combining these two equations, now it is possible to write V naught equal to, we know that it is minus GM into RL dash VGS. Okay, this is what? From equation 1. From equation 4 again we are going to get what is this VGS term. Okay, so therefore further we can rewrite V naught including the VGS now, minus GM RL dash into, so now I'll include the VGS terms. So VGS is equal to RG by RG plus RSIG into VSIG into 1 by 1 plus S by omega naught. Okay, so now in this we have to take out what? The ratio of V naught and VSIG. So therefore V naught by VSIG is equal to, so now we'll write this minus term RG plus RSIG as it is. This is one term, into we have GM into RL dash, this into 1 by S by omega naught. Okay, so now this is, let us call this as equation 8. Now in this equation 8, we will recognize the product of this Rg by Rg plus RSIg and Gm RL dash as Am. Okay, so therefore by writing Am is our gain, Rg plus RSIg into Gm into RL dash. Okay, so now we can rewrite equation 8. Okay, so rewriting the equation 8, we have V naught by VSIg equal to, now it is Am divided by 1 plus S by what we have actually omega naught. In place of omega naught, now we can write omega h. Okay, so this omega h is introduced because we are at the analysis of high frequency response of the amplifier. Okay, so where Am represents the mid band gain, Am is the mid band gain, and this omega naught, which is nothing but now omega h. Okay, so this is nothing but now 1 by C in into RSIg dash. So take it as equation 10. So therefore omega h can be written as what? 2 pi fh is equal to 1 by C in into R dash SIg. Okay, so therefore fh is equal to 1 by 2 pi C in, input capacitance C in into R dash SIg. Okay, so therefore this is an important relation which shows the FH, that is upper 3 dB cutoff frequency FH. So now this FH, it depends on input capacitance C in, as well as it depends on R dash SIg. Okay, so we know what is again C in. C in is nothing but, again it is CGS, gate to source capacitance, plus C equivalent capacitance. Okay, but again what is C equivalent capacitance? CGD into 1 plus GM into RL dash. Okay, so therefore now in the entire common source amplifier response, whatever the FH term is there, that is higher cutoff frequency, 3 dB cutoff frequency FH is there. So this will be greatly influenced by the input capacitance C in, as well as the resistance R dash SIg. What is this R dash SIg? It is nothing but the parallel combination of signal in internal resistance R signal and the input R in. Okay, input resistance of the amplifier. Okay, so but usually we know that whatever this Rg is there, bias resistance Rg, its value is very high and it can be neglected, that is almost open circuit. So therefore R dash SIg can be almost equal to RSIg only. Okay, so therefore it follows from this discussion that as the resistance has come in the denominator, a very high value of this R dash SIg, okay, which can be equal to simply RSIg. Okay, the value of FH can be reduced. Okay, so this is what is the conclusion, and also another observation from this is, so the total input capacitance, okay, the total input capacitance Cin, whatever has come in the denominator here, the major part of this Cn is nothing but C equivalent only. Okay, so that is here from this equation we know that, okay, in the input capacitance in this equation, the major part will be this CGD into 1 plus GM into RL dash, or that is the majority of the capacitance will be provided by this equivalent capacitance C equivalent only. Okay. So these are what are some of the points related with the equation FH. Okay. So therefore, based on this expression, FH expression, as well as we have other input capacitance calculations also, so we can easily calculate the value of FH for a given common source amplifier, provided you know what is RG, drain resistor RD, as well as the load resistor RL, and also the output resistance of the MOSFET R0, etc. Okay. So therefore, in the next session, we'll take the other important part of this frequency response, that is the low frequency response. So with this session will be concluded. Thank you.